Here's a problem that I have with this month's Q-Wave. This month, there's a tool that if you use it, will increase your likability with patients. My problem is, I don't think a lot of us are gonna use it. Like, early in my career, I realized how important patient satisfaction was. Like, good medicine is based on patient satisfaction. And I found that if I didn't really click with patients, things seem to come back on me, complaints or problems. So I realized early that I better, as a general rule, keep patients and nurses happy. So is there a tool that can be helpful? Now, what if you're not liked? What if in medicine you're not liked? And if we look at Prescani scores, which is a pretty good representation of likability, if you're in the bottom third of your Prescani scores, you have about 2.5 times more complaints, you're two times as likely to have risk management issues, and you are 110% more likely to have lawsuits. So likability is important to make your life better. Now, if we look at the data, are there any things that are consistently done by people that are well-liked? And this has been studied. You know, what are the high performers of the Prescani score? What are some things that they've done? Well, they smile, they make eye contact, they shake hands, they acknowledge and apologize for wait times. They begin with an open-ended question. They do non-medical gestures and they overestimate time. So are there keys, are there things that are consistently done by people that are well-liked? There are. Now, first and foremost, I'm going to give you a mnemonic and a tool that if you apply them, your Prescani scores and thus your likability are going to go up, but that still begs the bigger question. Do you really care? Like, do you care? Like, do you even care about patient satisfaction scores? Or do you just go to work and do your job? And I say that because I know me and how I was as a clinician, and for a long time, I didn't care. I was just going to do my job. And then I realized I was getting in trouble and I was getting dinged. And finally I realized when people like me, every part of my life is better. I love it now when a patient comes in and sees me and says, "Wait, you saw me last year. I'm so glad you're on again," you know? There's not that momentary pause of, "Oh crap, did I not work well with this patient?" I found that every part of my life has been better when I started focusing on patient satisfaction and really trying to serve the patients. So if you don't care, everything I'm going to say is moot. If you are a supervisor, if you administer like leadership to other clinicians, this mnemonic is going to be a tool to increase your likability if practiced. And the tool is, the mnemonic is piano, piano, P-I-A-N-O. Every patient, play the piano, P-I-A-N-O. So the P stands for, it's a power opening. When you walk in the room, it is game time, show is on. So what's a power opening? You smile, you make eye contact, and you shake hands. You smile, you make eye contact, and you shake hands. I mean, in the COVID era, we would make an appropriate greeting. Okay, that might be an elbow bump. Eyes introduction, my name is John Belinsky, I'm a physician assistant, and I'm gonna be taking care of you today. P-I-A, the A stands for we acknowledge and apologize for time, okay? The two biggest complaints in Prescani data is poor quality communication and time delays. Wait a second, let's just acknowledge, hey, I'm sorry that you waited. And I know sometimes it can be very frustrating waiting in a doctor's office or in an emergency room. But then we give the open-ended statement. How can I help you today? What brought you in to see us? N is a non-medical gesture. Guys, do something that shows that you cared. Bring him a pillow, bring him a blanket, bring him a cup of coffee, bring him some juice. Do something that shows that you care for them and you're not just a machine. And then when it comes to time, guys, always overestimate time. Always overestimate time. Time is an expectation that we set, and oftentimes we don't want to upset them, so it'll just be a few moments. Okay, well, what's a few moments? That's very ambiguous. So if you really care about patients and you really care about your job, consider playing the piano when it comes to patients. A power opening, introduction, acknowledge, apologize, and give an open-ended question. Use a non-medical gesture, do some non-medical gesture, and overestimate time. Folks, my name is John Belinsky from See Me for Life, where our whole goal is to help you maximize your mind. One of the things about medicine is it's a hard job. It's a hard job when you have the difference between patients and customers and people coming in being demanding, the new electronic medical records. It can be very stressful. If you are dealing with stress, or if you have any struggles with stress considering the climate of COVID today, CME for Life does have a session, a CME program called Burnout in Medicine. And it's excellent. It will give you real tools to look at your life. It's approved for Category 1 CME. And we have a number of CME programs like Emergency Medicine, Urgent Care, our Black Belt EKG program. And we still sell those programs with a gift card because we know that you learn better on your own time frame. And with the gift card, you can buy an iPad or gift card so you can study when it's most convenient for you. So our whole goal is to help you get great content and really apply it to patient care. Good luck, and see you in the next Q Wave.